guys. Welcome to this Biz Bestie interview. I am Renee Kaz, your host for this series and the founder of The Inspired Women. And tonight I have the amazing Annette Phillips with me. Hi, Annette.
Hi, Renee. Thank you for having me. I think you've been hugged.
Oh, you're very welcome. You're lovely to have you on here.
You're so lovely. I'm honoured. Deeply honoured. You're very kind. Thank you.
Well, you're very welcome. I'm very excited to have Annette on here tonight. Yeah, thanks for the love. Give us some love, guys, as you jump on. It takes a lot of guts to... Not for me. I obviously enjoy this. But for Annette and for other people jumping on these lives, it takes a lot of guts to get out there and do this. So, guys, make sure you do share some love with us. So the reason I started the Biz Bestie series is because I wanted to have a platform to get our members in front of each other so that we could learn more about each other. Hey, Jess, nice to see you, hun. So that we can learn more about each other's businesses and, you know, how we can help each other out. And yes, I'm very excited to have Annette here tonight. Just, I'm wondering if Facebook is having fun because sometimes it takes, usually we've got more people on here. Hey, Jen, nice to see you. But that's okay. I think we can jump into it.
Sure.
You ready?
Yeah.
Ready to have some fun? All right.
Always.
So, what is your business, Annette?
Renee, what is my business?
What is your business? Take Two. Annette has an app called Take Two, 2 minutes to a better relationship. If you haven't downloaded it, make sure you download it now from the app, after this interview, from the Apple App Store. I've downloaded my copy, of course. And you'll be pleased to know that it is already number 15 in the App Store for its genre. And if you just put in Take Two in the search, it's the first one that comes up. You can't miss it. Can't miss it at all. So, Annette, tell us a bit about Take Two and why you launched it.
So, Take Two is an app created to strengthen relationships, Renee. I went to a business conference where I met a woman who stood up in front of 100 strangers and talked about how she wanted to kill her husband. And I thought,
yeah, I can identify with that. Yes.
And so could everyone in the room, but no one actually talks about this. So I bumped into a mum at school and we came up with this idea of creating an app where we've taken the best of the best psychological inspiration, therapy, couples therapy inspiration, science-based facts around human potential, human development, and put them all into bite-sized chunks into the app. So it only takes you 2 minutes to recalibrate when you're in a stressful situation or need a bit of guidance. And you can set your app to a time that suits you. I set mine at 7 a.m. So I start the day in a nice way.
So if you're having a bit of an interest, a bit of a pickle with your partner, that would be a good time to pick up your phone and go to the Take Two app and see what inspiration and guidance you're given.
Well, yes, but I prefer to use mine so I start my day well. And so when those challenges come up, I'm already in a better state of mind, calm state of mind.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That works. I definitely agree with that. And I like that. Like with meditation, you're starting the day meditating because then that helps keep the stress lower than if you don't meditate to begin the day.
That's right. It's not a great thing. So my partner, Andrew, gets his at 4 o'clock. So he comes home after he's read his quote in a calm state. And, he's a better partner, better father, more beautiful person.
I don't think that's possible because he's already amazing.
He's amazing.
Hi, Andrew, if you're watching. And so when did you guys launch the app?
We launched December 2017 and we hit number 25 in the lifestyle category on the App Store a month or so ago. And then we jumped up to number 15, which is very exciting.
Very exciting. That's very, very good. And guys, download the app. Give her some reviews. Give Annette some reviews. Give her some 5 stars and help her get up to number 1 because that is where Take Two deserves to be. Okay, so Annette and I have been friends for a while as well. And I've heard a fair bit about your journey along the way because developing an app, that's hard gaff. There's a lot involved with that. And it always takes... Well, out of everyone I've spoken to that's developed an app, it always takes a lot longer than they anticipate.
Absolutely.
What's been some of the challenges you've had what are things that you wish you'd known when you started out to help you overcome or prevent some of those challenges that you've had along the way?
Well, firstly, I wish I had have known that I could actually do it. So I think I had that handbrake on of who am I,
Yeah, who am I to do this?
Absolutely, in the beginning. So I wish I had have known that I can do this, and you can do what you set your heart to do.
Yeah.
I wish I had have stopped looking at all the shiny objects that come along. So I wish I've had a focused on the end product and not get distracted.
So the shiny objects being other things that come along. Hey, Lisa, nice to see you. Hey, Laura, thanks for joining us, guys. Give Annette a bit of love if you're online so she knows you're there. So yeah, those shiny objects, those, tell us a bit more about that. Like, what's some things that might be an example of that, do you think?
Like doing courses that I thought I should do but didn't really need to do. Researching areas of things that I didn't really need to research. So basically, sorting out what your core business is,
yeah,
and only paying attention to that. As Nicole Ashby says, if it relates to your core business, go for it. If it doesn't relate to your core business, don't bother with it.
Yeah. Mm. So Nicole Ashby, she was on our Biz Bestie series earlier, actually. She's from High Profit Media. Yeah, very knowledgeable and insightful lady. Yeah, I definitely agree that. Do you think maybe it was a confidence thing that sent you off on that path of all those other shiny objects and going, well, not maybe doubting whether you could do it, going back to your first point, and then it's like, how can I busy myself to kind of sabotage myself subconsciously so that I don't actually launch it, because, oh no, I've got to research this, so I've got to do that, and I've got to do all these things before I'm ready to launch, because that's, you know, a common myth that...
Absolutely. It's fear. It's fear-based behaviour, and I thought, well, who am I to be developing an app? A 51-year-old woman who... just recently bought an iPhone. And so I did. A lot of fears came up for me, and I wish I had have known it was just fear, who is procrastination's best friend.
Yeah.
And they talk about you behind your back. And so I wish I had have not done that. What else? I wish I had have known that I didn't have to know everything,
yeah,
do everything, and be everything.
Mm-hmm.
Enlist help, ask for help. People are very keen to give you help.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. And also I wish that I had have known that facing difficulties, mm-hmm, is not such a big deal. You eat the frog first thing in the morning.
Get through the tough stuff early on. Hey, Irina, nice to see you on here. Yeah, I definitely agree with those. When often I find like I'll put off certain things in my business, doing certain things, or even recently I was billed horrendously high for something from a medical practitioner, and I was like, this doesn't make sense, like this is ridiculous, and they tried to bill me for something that didn't occur, and I was like, we never had a consultation, so please take that from your bill. And anyway, it's been an ongoing interesting situation, but I would always just like put it off for so long, and then as soon as I deal with it, it's like, oh, actually that took 10 minutes. I was like, it took 20 minutes, it wasn't as big of a deal as I thought it was, but the energy that would take from me, and because it'd be on the back of my mind, it's something I have to deal with, then that is why you want to deal with these things, because it's taking so much of your energy and preventing you from moving forward when you're distracted with those things. Now, I know there was something recent in the group, in the Inspired Women group, mm-hmm, that you shared with Carmen Watts. I'm wondering, yes, if you'd be open to sharing that with us. Carmen asked a special question about visualizing, and she wanted some help with getting clear on her big vision and bringing forth her vision into her life. Hey, Irina. Hi, Karen. Nice to see you. And yeah, did you want to perhaps tell us a bit about that process and why you use it and how to do it? And has that helped your business?
It has helped my business. It's helped absolutely, it's helped my business. It's called the Pink Bubble Technique, and it was developed by Shakti Gawain. Do you know Shakti?
Not personally, no.
But you know of her.
No.
So she was she wrote a creative visualization in the 70s,
yeah,
as a book to give to her friends. It became so successful. But she taught the Pink Bubble Technique.
Okay.
So would you like me to take you through this?
Yes, please.
All right, I'll do it with you.
Okay.
Okay.
I'm not going to go into a psychedelic trance state or something, am I? Because I might freak out about that.
And you don't have to speak through it.
Okay.
So that the audience can do this as well. So.
Okay, guys, let's all do this together. I find in the situation I'm in, it's taken so much of my time, yet I'm finding it hard to separate from it. Yes. Yeah, well, give this a go, Lisa. Give the this pink bubble technique a go.
Okay, so close your eyes. Take a very long, slow, deep breath. And another. one more. Now visualize something that you want to have happen and see it in your mind's eye. Now really visualize yourself in that situation, in that future that you're visualizing. Feel yourself in the situation. Smell what it smells like. Can you hear sounds of being in that visualization? Really feel deeply into it. See yourself in that situation. Now I want you to hold that visualization in your mind's eye. Wrap a pink bubble around that visualization. Release it to the universe. Thank the universe. Say thank you.
Thank you.
And then let the universe sort out the details.
Okay. Let's do another one. So guys, if you just joined us, hey Cheryl, lovely to have you on here. I've got Annette with me from, I feel really grounded and calm now. She launched the Take 2 app recently, or in December last year, which is number 15 on the App Store. I've got to say the AppTunes store, the App Store. It was great, wasn't it, Karen? And Annette's just shared with us a really powerful technique, the pink bubble technique, about how you can manifest absolutely anything into your life. And that's how you said you called in your amazing husband, Andrew.
I did, yes. Interestingly enough, I used to visualize an apartment in Cottesloe because there's no way I could afford a house. But now we live in a house.
A beautiful home.
Beautiful home. What else have I visualized? Oh, 3 months in France, living with the whole family when I turned 50. I'm visualizing some things I probably shouldn't talk about because.
Okay, that's all right.
Around the app. So visualizing.
Number one on the App Store with lots of amazing reviews, which we're all going to give her when we jump off the live tonight, obviously.
But also I've pink bubbled health.
Yes.
Work, you know, if you're having a struggle at work, I've pink bubbled so it's an easier situation to be in.
Mm.
Also, not just physical things, but peace and calm and, well, Andrew. I did manifest
so
it.
So lovely. Okay, gosh, I feel a bit like, oh, do we have to keep doing this now? Can we just sit and chat, do more pink bubbles? Okay, so my next question is, There's more. We've even got a steak knife set. What do you love best about being part of the Inspired Women community? What? Unleash, Annette. Unleash.
Were you, to start off with?
You're only human.
Yeah. What you've created is so special and so beautiful. Soulful, generous, big-hearted, collaborative, delicious, beautiful women that you've attracted and you have nourished. And I just love being around women. And to be honest, I actually thought I'd be too old for the group, but I have made friends with women a lot younger than me. And they don't mind that I'm there.
No.
So just beautiful, accepting, tolerant, intelligent, just gorgeous women. I love being in the group.
If you'd like to get around more ladies like that, we've got our next event on the 21st of June. That's a good little time
segue.
Bit of a drop there, a bit of a promo. The link is in the group on the pinned post. You can get the details there. But yeah, thank you. And I definitely agree. I mean, the group is all about connecting and creating real lasting connections with other dynamic business women. So it's beautiful, the amazing ladies we have in there. Now, do you have any strategic partnerships or particular businesses or people you'd like to connect with in our community that you might not have met yet?
I do. I think my app is a really powerful tool for anyone in a relationship. It's also been powerful for people who are single to use it to as a mindfulness tool. And even one user manifested the love of her life using the app. But what I would really love to do is to get into the FIFO community, because there's a lot of special challenges being in a FIFO relationship. And anyone in the media in a FIFO relationship, I would love to partner with to really spread the message. And if you're in the media, I think Take Two would be a good fit, because it's like sending a love note. You can send quotes. It's like sending a love note to your partner. And if you're up in wherever on a mine and just send a quote that's come for you with a little kiss or thinking of you, it's just a beautiful way to say I'm thinking of you. But also, you know, there's a lot of accidents happen on the mines when phone calls are made to home. And this, it's stressful. And so just to have, be calm and grounded before you call, have a look at your quote and then make the call. I think I love that.
Very good. Yeah. Excellent. And how can people get hold of you? What's the best way to get in touch with you or find out more about the app?
Well, the app's on the App Store, and you just type in Take Two, T-A-K-E-T-W-O.
Or even the number. I did the number.
No,
that worked.
Oh. Oh, well, we must be doing very well. Better to do TWO.
Okay.
That's on the App Store, or our website is take2app.com.au.
And we can share all this in the comments below shortly. Mm-hmm. My husband and I were interviewed many years ago by The Australian because we're a FIFO family. Mm-hmm. Oh. Lisa could be a connection for
you. Lisa, okay. Beautiful. I'll have to reach out.
Awesome. All right, well, we'll put those details below so people can get in touch. And yeah, guys, check out the app, download it from the App Store, Take Two, and make sure you leave a review, 5 stars or more. Some lovely comments. And then that can help Annette get to number one on the App Store, because that's what we want, don't we?
Well, we want to have good relationships, because, you know.
Oh, yeah.
When your relationship's good, everything's good. When your relationship is a bit off, everything's worse.
Well, that's another way to look at it. Or you can make it a competition and get that type A personality like I have come out and really get excited about it and make it a competition. All right. Thanks so much for joining us, guys. And thank you, Annette.
Thanks, Renee.
Have yourselves a lovely evening.
Thank you.
Adios.